waters, but some of them also live in the fresh waters. Can you guess which animal it is? That's right! We're going to talk about eels. What are we waiting for? Let's dive in.
Are more than 700 eel species. Here are some of them. The giant moray eel. Giant moray eel may not be as long as the slender giant moray eel. The longest slender giant moray eel that has been recorded was 4 meters long. But the giant moray eel are heavy giants, weighing 30 kilograms. The zebra moray eel. Does it look like a zebra? Next up is the garden eel. Most eels like to live by themselves, but garden eels like to live in colonies. Each garden eel lives in a burrow. It'll come out to eat zooplankton, but it will stay in the burrow for its entire life. Hello, hello, a new zooplankton. This is the European conger, also called the conger. It's the heaviest eel in the world. The heaviest that was found weighed 158 kilograms! What other animals weigh about the same as the European conger? Bottlenose dolphin, bull shark, and giant squid! The gulper eel. Some eels live in deep sea. The gulper eel is black and it got a really big mouth. What's cool is that it has a flashy tail. The tail can flash pink or red, kind of like the anglerfish. Do you think the deep sea would look like the universe, with many deep sea creatures glowing and flashing lights? I wonder if there's a gulper eel out there. Ribbon eel. Does it look like a ribbon? Speaking of ribbons, look at how the gymnast twirls the ribbon. So beautiful! Did you know that electric eels are not an eel? They are closer to catfish. How can we tell an eel from a sea snake? First, eels have flatter bodies. Sea snakes are rounder. And remember, eels are fish. Eels have fins, but sea snakes don't. That's the dorsal fin of the moray eel. It's connected all the way to its tail, the caudal fin. Eels also have gills, so they can just breathe underwater. Sea snakes have lungs, so even though they can stay long enough, they need to go back up to catch air.
Hello, hello! Subscribe if you love learning about us!
Let's take a look at the eel's life cycle. All fresh and seawater eels come from an egg in the ocean. The larva's body is see-through. It grows and floats around the ocean. Larvae that gets close to the freshwater becomes a glass eel. Glass eels get ready to move the freshwater, the rivers and lakes. The young eels are called elvers. Elvers' bodies are no longer seafood, and they start looking like eels. I guess that's why some people call elvers baby eels. For most species, it takes several years for an elver to become a full-grown adult eel. Just keep swimming, 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 swimming. I'm hungry. Most eels are carnivores. They like to eat meat. It depends on the species, but some eels like to eat crustaceans like crabs, shrimps, and lobsters. They also like fish and cephalopods like squid and octopuses. Here's a giant moray eel hunting an octopus. Yikes! Fun fact! Sometimes the giant moray eels teams up with this guy, the grouper. Hey buddy, let's go hunting. Yeah, yeah, yeah! Eel in the world, European conger eel or the garden eel? The answer is A, European conger eel. Which stage of the life cycle is the eel at right before it becomes an adult? Elver or larva? The answer is elver. Which one would eels like to eat more? A, algae, B, shrimp. The answer is shrimp.
That's a wrap for Dorothy's Ocean Book on Eels. I hope you enjoyed this episode and don't